বিসমিল্লাহির রহমানির রহিম। সম্মানিত প্রিয় দর্শক মণ্ডলী, আসসালামু আলাইকুম ওয়া রাহমাতুল্লাহি ওয়া বারাকাতুহু। সাদর আমন্ত্রণ জানাচ্ছি আপনাদের সকলকে যে যেখান থেকে বসে আজকের বিশেষ চ্যারিটি ইন প্রোগ্রেস অনুষ্ঠানটি দেখছেন। আশা করছি আপনারা যে যেখানেই আছেন সবাই ভালো আছেন এবং আপনাদের ভালো থাকার প্রত্যাশা আমাদের সব সময়ের জন্য। আপনারা জানেন চ্যারিটি ইন প্রোগ্রেস অনুষ্ঠানটি আমরা সাজিয়ে থাকি বিভিন্ন ধরনের চ্যারিটি সংগঠনের কর্তৃপক্ষের সাথে, তাদেরকে নিয়ে আমরা আলোচনা করে থাকি, তাদের সংগঠন নিয়ে আমরা জানার চেষ্টা করি এবং তাদের প্রোগ্রেস কী হয়েছে কী হচ্ছে এই সব বিষয় নিয়ে আমরা এই অনুষ্ঠানে তুলে ধরার চেষ্টা করি এবং তাদের ভবিষ্যতে কী কী পরিকল্পনা আছে, বর্তমানে কী কী কাজ করছেন তারা, এই সব বিষয় নিয়ে আমরা চ্যারিটি ইন প্রোগ্রেসে অনুষ্ঠানে আলোচনা করে থাকি। আজও ইনশাআল্লাহ তার ব্যতিক্রম হবে না। আজকে যে সংগঠন আমাদের সাথে উপস্থিত আছেন তার নাম হচ্ছে ক্যাপ ফাউন্ডেশন, ইন আদার ওয়ার্ডস কমিউনিটি এগেনস্ট পভার্টি, নামেই বোঝা যাচ্ছে। তাদের কাজ শুরু হয়েছিল 2011 সালে এই ব্রিটেনের মাটি থেকে এবং তারপরে তারা বিভিন্ন ধরনের ইন্টারন্যাশনাল প্রজেক্টের সাথে তারা যুক্ত হয়ে গেছে। ইটস এ ফেয়ারলি আ নিউ অর্গানাইজেশন, হাউএভার ইউ হ্যাভ সিন এভরি ওয়ান ইটস ওয়ার্ক, দে প্রজেক্টস, দে এফএস অ্যান্ড হোয়াট এভার ওয়ার্কস দে হ্যাভ ডান সো ফার, ইটস অল অ্যাভেলেবল নট ওনলি অন দ্য ওয়েবসাইট, ইউ ক্যান ফাইন্ড দেম অন দি ফেসবুক, ইউ ক্যান সি দোজ ভিডিওস as well on the YouTube. And today, inshallah, we'll be discussing with them about their future projects, their current projects, and what plans they have ahead. And all of this, inshallah, we'll try and touch in our tonight's episode for discussion. But before we begin, we'll introduce the guests that are there with us in the studio. I'll start from my right, and in fact, immediate right, I've got Brother Abdul Noor, who is the founder and CEO of CAP Foundation. To his right, we've got Abdul Samad, who is the chairman of CAP Foundation. Then on my immediate left, we have got Sister Afia Samad, who is the management board member of CAP Foundation. And to her left, we have got Bilqis Murad, who is also a management board member. First of all, assalamu alaikum, and thank you very much for joining with us. Now, Brother Noor, if I can start with you, as you are the CEO and founder of CAP Foundation, if you can give us a little bit of brief introduction about CAP Foundation and then touch upon how was last year for CAP Foundation, in other words, 2017.
Inshallah. First of all, thank you, Qamar Dubai and Channel-S for inviting us, alhamdulillah. Channel-S is obviously one of our media partners, giving us platform to feedback to our UK donors and supporters, and it's a blessing to update everyone from Channel-S. CAP Foundation, we started in 2011 and with the intention of supporting the destitute people in Bangladesh, especially in Greater Sylhet Division. We started with one Upojala, which is sub-district, and alhamdulillah, up to now, we have managed to touch base and worked with more than 35 sub-district Upojala, covering majority, about 70 to 80% of the Greater Sylhet Division. We have also been working with Netrokuna Moyamonsingh District Division. We've been working in Chittagong Division, Brahmanbaria, Dhaka. These are the areas where we have focused. We've also, in 2017, we have done a massive amount of work with the Rohingya brothers and sisters, completing many projects. I'm going to come to that.
We'll ask you about that later on. I mean, thank you very much for that brief introduction. Now, if I ask you in a nutshell, how would you rate yourself, or how would you rate CAP Foundation in terms of success last year?
Okay, obviously rating and praising is, we leave that to our supporters and donors. And alhamdulillah, it is a impressive, progressive delivery we have done year to year. And it's just great to show that how much we have done in the last 6-7 years. We have started from one Upojala. We've now covered more than 35 Upojala, and we're also working in different divisions in Bangladesh. So we're not just staying within Greater Sylhet Division. We have actually donors from every corner of this country, alhamdulillah. And there are little teams in different places in UK as well. They also come forward whenever there's an event or whenever there's a campaign we start.
I'll come back to that as you talked about teams. I'll be more interested to find out more about the teams across the UK. Now, if I can start with Brother Abdul Samad, you are the chairman of CAP Foundation. Now, we have heard that CAP Foundation initiated from UK and then working in Bangladesh. Is it only restricted to Bangladesh, or do you work across or outside Bangladesh?
That's a very good question, actually. Assalamu alaikum, viewers. Thank you for having us on board and to the show. Your question is a fantastic question. We not only working in Bangladesh, we work in the UK. We work with partnership with other charity organizations, so other parts of the world as well. So parts of Africa, Middle East, you know, in Syria, etc. So we do branch out to other areas.
So wherever there are affected communities, societies, you work, the organization work.
But the unique point of CAP Foundation is we got people on the ground. So it's no point us going on the ground in another country. So we partner with other charity organizations who could do that on the ground. So likewise, vice versa, people partner with us because they know we're doing a fantastic work in Bangladesh. We've got people on the ground. We've got over 150, now 200 volunteers working in Bangladesh and a very dedicated team.
And when you say 200 volunteers in Bangladesh, they are without any payments?
Without any pay. Okay. With the pure intention to please Allah and do this for their hereafter.
Thank you very much for clarifying. I'll come back to you again. I need to find out more about CAP Foundation. Now, if I can start with Sister Afia Samad. Now, Walaikum Salaam wa rahmatullah. Now, my first question to you would be, normally we don't see a lot of sisters involved with a lot of charity organizations out there. I know they are there. Obviously, our big donors are our sisters from background. Month of Ramadan, our sisters, our mothers donate generously. Now, if I can start briefly with you, how did you get involved with CAP Foundation?
I started working in the community. I work in Tower Hamlets, and I've been working with the Bangladeshi community for about 20 odd years. And I started getting involved, doing volunteer work with other charity organizations. And I came across CAP Foundation, and I looked at the work they were doing, and because it was 100% donation, I wanted to get more involved. So I started attending different activities, events in the community, and I got to know Noor, introduced myself to Noor, and Noor asked me if I wanted to get more involved and be part of it. And that's how I got involved, and because there was an opportunity for sisters to get involved, and CAP Foundation has allowed women to be part of the charity organization. And yes, of course, most of the donors in the community are sisters, coming from women in our community. And CAP Foundation allowed us and given us that opportunity to get involved, and that was the reason I got involved, because I wanted to do more charity, I wanted to give back more to the community.
Great, good to know that. I'll come back to you and I'll find out more about, I know you've been involved with a lot of fantastic projects, I've been told, so we'll find out more in details from you. Okay. Now to my last guest of this segment is Bilqis Murad, Sister Bilqis Murad. Walaikum Salaam wa rahmatullah. You're a management board member. If you can slightly little bit explain about how you are involved with the CAP Foundation.
Okay, so with CAP, I deal with the admin side, the finance side.
Okay.
But as a team, as an organisation, so we kind of all support each other within these roles. So I will help Samad Bhai, I will help Noor Bhai, Afiafa as well, in what we need to do for each project, so the preparation for the events, to make sure from beginning to end on how we can all support each other, to motivate each other, to reach out to our donors, to be able to fundraise for the public, to be able to make sure that it's a smooth running of the operation. Of course, as fundraising, we meet people that need help, and it's quite an emotional thing to do, and it's about motivating each other and kind of working as a team. So although our management, I would say we're kind of all one happy family.
I mean, good to know that. The key word they've used, working as a team. I think in any event or any project, to make it successful, we have to, always key, the important part is the work in a team. And thank you very much for enlightening us with your suggestion or knowledge as well. Now, there's a key word that's been used there, and that's finance and how the funding goes on. Now, the biggest question, I would ask this specifically to Abdunnoor, by people have questions when it comes to transparency.
Absolutely.
Now, a lot of our audiences, we get a lot of questions from our community. They ask about how can we assure that the donation that we are giving are actually reaching the destitute, the actual needy persons.
Okay.
How would you respond to that question?
All right. First of all, we as an organization operate on a 100% donation policy. So every single penny that Publix donates has to go to his ground for his project work. Now, there's a big question, how does the operation runs? The operation runs from our gift aid. There's standing orders. There's some healthy donors who focuses particularly on the development side of the organization, but not the project work. We also have small activities to generate income to support the admin. I'm just going to give you an example of one project. For example, Waterwell. There's minimum 8 to 10 families has to come forward to apply for a single water well. Now, the team in Bangladesh, this is just to make it value for money. They will go out there, the research team will go out there, find the needs, and there's another team we have within CAP Foundation in Bangladesh, the inspection team. They will go out to inspect what was found, and they will then consult with the village Murabbi and all the applicant sit down together, and they will come to a solution that where does this water well will be installed. So for example, between the 10-15 families, the water well will place within the middle of the family, and that particular family will sign to say, long as the water well is placed, this particular land is not mine anymore. Once we have the agreement, then we go out to install so that it doesn't come back to us 5 years, 10 years down the line to say this particular family might say, this is mine.
Okay.
There's a signature.
So there's a contract or an agreement in place.
Absolutely.
Okay.
And once all the projects been completed, we bring the photograph details, and you as a donor, we will communicate with you to pass all the details back to you. Not necessarily that you're asking for the information. You've given the donation, alhamdulillah, but it is our duty as an organization to feedback to you where exactly your money has been spent.
So basically, if our viewers want to find out where exactly this project is taking place, how the funds are being used,
absolutely,
it's very transparent.
Absolutely.
And you can provide, as an organization, all the relevant details, they can see.
Not only that, our end of year accounts, which is submitted
to the Charity Commission,
it's transparent and available for all the public to view. So what people that donate for donations is done under restricted funds.
Mm-hmm.
So all those funds are put towards the work
specific.
And projects.
So basically, if you're saying that we are raising money for this particular project, mm-hmm. the money is being donated for that
absolutely.
Particular project without getting it diverted to
anywhere
else.
And that become restricted funds.
Restricted funds.
So you as a donor has donated for a shelter. This is restricted, isn't it? We cannot utilize this money in other projects. And we will only utilize this money for the shelter project. And all the information we communicate back to the donors, feedback to them exactly where their where the shelter has been built. When they go to Bangladesh, we sometime advise the donors, whenever you go to Bangladesh, if you go to our office in Sylhet, we will arrange the volunteers to take you to the beneficiaries so that you can personally meet them and find out exactly where the money is spent.
Thank you very much for clarifying the important aspect here. Now, Brother Abdul Samad, the question to you would be, we've heard about 2017.
Mm-hmm.
We had a brief understanding about what 2018 is all about. If you can touch upon the main project that you're focusing in 2018.
So alhamdulillah, 2018, we're going to be carrying on with our current projects as well. But one of the main projects we're going to do is an antenatal clinic in Mahinga. Mm-hmm.
I'll come to the sisters for more in detail.
Apart
from that, what other projects are there?
Other projects, we've got five academies, new academies. So mm-hmm. where we used to build shelter before, we're branching out. We used to do shelter houses, which we're doing now. We've thought of building schools for communities. So what better way to to give charity than teach knowledge to children and give them the facility of that in areas where there's no facilities available. So we're looking at five academies.
And where are they based?
They're going to be based...
The five academies is going to be is actually built. We will be going there to launch it. There's going to be there's actually six. One in Rohingya.
Okay.
One in Moli Bazar district. Mm-hmm. Two in Sylhet district, Khanaigad and Zointa, and two in Shunamganj district, Bishamburpur and Tahirpur. We're also going to be launching our first mosque. We built
okay.
for our sister, late sister who has passed away, Sister Shamimara.
On behalf of
Sister Shamimara. So that's also in Bishamburpur. We will be going there to open that as well.
Okay, inshallah. I'll find out more details about it. But first, because it's been touched, the antenatal clinic. Now, for my viewers, just make it simple. What is antenatal clinic?
Okay, antenatal clinic. We will be opening that in a Rohingya camp, and this is particularly providing it's a maternity hospital.
Providing care
to 70,000 pregnant women of sisters that are based literally in the camp at the moment because there are no other facilities. There are other charity organisations, but our aim is to provide permanent care, not on a day-to-day basis. And this maternity clinic will provide that care for sisters. It's on the process of being built. We're going to launch it. Hopefully, we're traveling next week to Bangladesh, and we'll be working in the clinic next following week, and it will be open on the 10th, inshallah.
Next weekend. February.
Actually, the clinic will be opening probably 6th or 7th February.
Okay.
So the team... it's already organized, the doctors, nurses, midwife, paramedics, you know, caretakers, administration. It is very difficult to get the authorization because it's medical.
Yeah.
It's a specific area, subject, isn't it? So they do so much scrutiny. And alhamdulillah... The government, the authority, they do so much scrutiny. Alhamdulillah, because of our good partnership with the government and authority, we have been given to open the antenatal clinic. Before I say that, I just want to give you a brief update on what we have already done in Rohingya. Alhamdulillah, I've taken a team back in October, and our mental health camp is still running. As you know, every single person that came across has been traumatized.
Mm-hmm.
They've seen their, mothers, sisters raped on front of them, chopped, killed by the mugs. We have been facilitated them with mental support for both adults and children. That's also running. We've alhamdulillah delivered 200 sanitation, just over 50 water well, 50 bathrooms, and loads of food packs during our trip in October. So that's already done. And also in December, we have done a winter emergency distribution, which we've sent 240-foot containers from this country, which included clothing, shoes, duvet, blankets, medicine, toys for children's, all of that, alhamdulillah. So we're actually quite heavily working in Rohingya at the moment, and this is an opportunity for us to continue the work with a specific, what we're trying to achieve here, Kamal Bhai, is we don't want to go and do handouts. We want to focus on the specific needs that people are dying for. So the antenatal clinic is very crucial to service the pregnant women and safe deliver their baby.
I mean, we've seen on the news a lot of expecting women have crossed over.
Absolutely.
The challenges.
Yeah, absolutely.
And we've also seen on the news, on various news channels, the babies, how they're delivered, in what circumstances they were delivered.
Yeah.
I mean, is this one of the primary...
So this is one of our permanent projects based in the camp, and it's an ongoing project. And actually, we have a team of medical professionals, midwives, nurses and doctors, and the hospital will provide antenatal care and postnatal care
to
both mother and child.
Okay, I'll come back to it more in detail. So it's just time for a short break. I'll find out after the break more about this clinic.
Yeah.
And I'll ask more about if you can shadow some lights, because a lot of people might not know what the clinic will provide.
I'll give you that.
প্রিয়দর্শক মণ্ডলী, সময় হচ্ছে একটি বিজ্ঞাপন বিরতিতে যাওয়ার। আমরা শুনেছি কিরকম ক্যাপ ফাউন্ডেশন কাজ করছেন বাংলাদেশের মাটিতে, স্পেশালি তারা রোহিঙ্গার সাথে কিরকম কাজ করছেন, এবং তাদের কাছ থেকে আমরা শুনলাম কি অবস্থায় তারা আছেন। এবং ইম্পর্টেন্ট বিষয়টি হচ্ছে যে মাগুলি, যে শিশুরা যে আসছেন, যে অবস্থায় আছেন, যে অবস্থায় বেবি ডেলিভারি হচ্ছে, এটা কিন্তু শুনলেই কিন্তু আমাদের গা কেঁপে ওঠে। ইনশাল্লাহ আমরা আরও আলোচনা করব বিরতির পর, তাদের কাছ থেকে জানার চেষ্টা করবো এই ক্লিনিকগুলো স্পেসিফিকলি কীরকম সাপোর্ট প্রোভাইড করে এবং কী কী চ্যালেঞ্জেসের সম্মুখীন হয়েছেন, এই সব বিষয় নিয়ে আমরা বিস্তারিত আলোচনা করব। কিন্তু একটি ছোট্ট বিরতির পর সঙ্গেই থাকুন। আসসালামু আলাইকুম।